Harry, that's not what I meant when I said between centers.
My bad.
HodgePodge. I like your beaver. I really like your beaver!
Welcome, everybody. In today's video, I'll be turning a three-winged vessel for the first time. I initially planned to be turning a bowl, however, I changed my mind halfway through coring out the inside.
Stay tuned to see what it became.
After getting the blank mounted, I wanted to make sure it was properly aligned, so I checked the three corners of the cube to see if they were in line. One of the corners seemed a little bit off, so I kind of readjusted and it seemed to help.
Aw, man, I gotta go back up here.
The first thing I wanted to do was remove enough wood to form a tenon. Turning a blank that has so much air, it's good to have the speed up as high as you feel comfortable with, so that way you can get a better cut.
Wood looks tasty.
You better keep my wood out of your mouth, Harry. At this stage, I was ready to turn the blank around, so I'm just getting rid of the waste wood.
Show off.
I knew a lot of this pyramid section would be turned away, so I kind of wanted to save some of it. So here I begin parting off part of it, which I considered using for some kind of lid. first formed a little tenon on the top section that I could grab hold of if I decided to turn something out of it. Left a little bit of wiggle room near the corners just in case the parting tool ended up doing some tear out on the sharp edges. At this point, I figured I was just going to be making a bowl because I didn't really like how the lid looked. Here I added some whiteboard to the background, which helps me see the ghost line of the rim better. Somewhere along this stage of the turning, I decided that I wanted to make a winged hollowform vessel. Thank you. I wanted to get a more defined line where the wing met the hollowform body, so here I switched to a detail gouge, which allowed me to get into that tight clearance area.
Too rough.
After a whole bunch of hand sanding, I applied some denatured alcohol to clean off the piece. For turning off the tendon and the foot, which I decided against, I found a jam chuck that I use for turning pepper mills. I was a little bit nervous mounting it because the piece had moved so much and the walls were around an eighth of an inch thick. I just took really light cuts and took my time, and it worked out all right. Because of the movement of the wood, I knew that when I turned off the foot, I'd have to do some blending, so that's what I'm doing here.
That looks really good. I hope nothing happens to it. You almost screwed that one up, didn't you, Robert?